Hi Cancer, welcome to my channel. I'm Miss Rose and this is Miss Rose Tarot. I'm really happy that you're here for your October general tarot reading, Cancer, Sun, Moon, Rising and Venus placements. This is your reading, guys. Now let's see what's going on for you in the month of October 2021, Cancer. Let's see. The Empress, the Four of Cups, the Two of Cups. Nice, guys. Wow. Let's find out more. Don't forget, these are free general readings. Some of the messages may resonate, some of them may not. If you feel like you need any more information, please make sure to check out your other placements, especially your moon, your Venus, and your rising sign. Also, I record readings especially for my single babes out there. So if you're single and if you want to know more about your love life, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon so you won't miss your singles reading. And if you are in a relationship and happy, please subscribe to my channel as well, of course. Okay, so nice. Okay, yes. Seven of Wands, Three of Swords, the Moon, the Hermit, Ace of Pentacles and the King of, sorry, the Knight of Swords is here. Definitely, I see this beautiful story here coming out of a dark place, Cancer. This is amazing, your energy, wow, okay. Your energy that is coming for you, if you don't feel strong right now, maybe you are still in the Hermit mode because the Hermit popped out, definitely here for you. Maybe you have some verbal placements. Could be the case. If you are still in the Hermit mode, if you are still recovering and healing from a heartbreak, because we do have the Three of Swords here, your energies are going to shift very, very soon. There's a new start, okay? Yes. Seven of Wands. Talking about the hope, talking about holding on and keep going, okay? Ace of Pentacles is coming. Wow. Earth energy for you. Knight of Swords and the Moon. It could be that there was a personal relationship. So this is not a love reading per se. This heartbreak here that is shown could be anything. This could be love related. This could be about a third party situation. This could be about something else here as well. A friend, a work situation, a colleague, something where you have been disappointed, something that hurt you. I can definitely see that way of Three of Swords. Yes, of course. For most of you, this could be about a friend or a love situation. And I feel like for quite some time, Cancer, you needed time for yourself. With the Hermit, with the Four of Cups, I feel like you couldn't let anybody in or any emotions in, and you were closing off to the people around you. You were like, no, I need to rest, I need to reset, I need to contemplate, I need to think about my life, about what I want, I need to think about this new start and recover from this Three of Swords energy. And it's coming, okay? Definitely, the shift is coming. And what I do see is that there could have been some truth revealed to you with the Moon and the Knight of Swords. The Knight of Swords is a card, I wouldn't say it's negative, but sometimes it's very like, just, you know, information just coming in really, really fast without any warning, okay? So sometimes this can mean that there was some truth revealed to you that has something to do with the Three of Swords. Maybe you were involved with a Pisces or with a air sign, a Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Okay, but Cancer, take it how it resonates, of course, for you. The better times are coming in. The Ace of Pentacles and the Two of Cups. Let's not forget about the Two of Cups. This is so beautiful. So there's definitely a new connection in your life that is going to happen for you. With the Two of Cups, we're talking about mutual feelings, mutual respect, equal give and take. No hurt, no pain. I don't see that. No imbalanced energy, okay? So with this Two of Cups, there could be a new soulmate coming in for others of you. It doesn't have to be romantic, okay? We can have more than one soulmate. Friends can be our soulmates, family members. Well, for others of you, this could be a new business partnership that will help you level up your own projects, your own business maybe, okay? But I do see for a lot of you that this is romantic. We also have the Empress, and this is the energy you're shifting towards to Cancer. So just hold on and pull through. Universe is really having your back right now, and the Empress energy is so beautiful. It's beautiful feminine energy. This card is associated with the planet Venus, and the planet Venus, of course, rules Taurus and Libra. So there's some beautiful Taurus and Libra energy here talking about fertile energy, creating something. And we have the Ace of Pentacles. So this could really be for a lot of you that you are going to be very, very busy with a new project, okay? Maybe you're... I just feel for a lot of you, you could be going on a journey, traveling somewhere new. And this could be the case. For others of you, I can see that there is a new workplace, a new job. So maybe you are in a transition period right now regarding your job, your workplace. And for others of you, this also means that in the future, in the near future, you will be very, very attractive to the people around you. You will be radiating from inside and out. So there's some healing going on for you, taking your time, but you will be satisfied again, and you will be very happy with yourself again, okay? And this is very nice because you will shine from the inside out and people will notice. So if you're single and if you feel like, yes, I want to get to know somebody new, this is definitely possible, Cancer, okay? Because people will turn their heads as well. And with the Ace of Pentacles, no matter what it is for you, the new projects, the journey, the new relationship, all of it, okay? Nothing is excluded. This new friendship, this new business partnership, it's here to stay. With this Earth energy, Capricorn, Taurus, and Virgo energy here, okay? So you are on the right track, Cancer, and soon you will feel this shift, this transformation as well. Okay, let's get out one card for you from the Universe Has Your Back Oracle deck. Only one message, please. One message. Here it is. It's this one. I will read it out to you, of course. It's a bit, yeah, you can, it's a bit, you know, faint. When I focus on my inner light, I see the world through the lens of love. And now, one message from the daily guidance from your angels oracle deck. As well, only one message, please. Here it is. Heart chakra. It says, love is the heart of the matter. Your heart is the center within your physical being attuned most to love. It's safe for you to love and be loved with an open heart as we stand by with perfect protection and guidance. So for some of you, you are really working on your emotions, on your heart chakra, letting people in again. I could see that you were closing them out because you were healing and you needed time for yourself. And now this will be different in the coming few weeks, okay? This is the energy that is transforming in your life. Let's check out some Lunology Oracle cards. Cancer, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. Ooh, okay. We have your dreams need a practical plan, and that's Taurus energy. I can definitely see if you want to make your dreams, your plans become reality, that there is very favorable energy in your reading for that. I told you definitely with the Ace of Pentacles, okay? Look, believe in the impossible. I love this card so much, the blue moon. once in a blue moon. And also, you have faith in your dreams. That's my other favorite card of the deck. This is so powerful from the Moonology Oracle cards. Have faith in your dreams and believe in the impossible. A fiery climax approaches, Aries energy. And nothing is yet set in stone. That's a mutable moon. Okay, now let's check out some romance angels for you guys. Energies for Cancer, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus placements, please. Some romance angels, please. Okay, so let me see. Yes, I can see the Three of Swords here. Unrequited love and release your ex popped out. For Pisces as well, and we have the moon in your reading, maybe you have some Pisces placements, okay? Release your ex. The time has come to clear your energy. And unrequited love, there's not enough attraction or chemistry to keep this relationship going. And we do have the Three of Swords, so this could be connected to the Three of Swords here. Okay? But you did release this person. If it's not an ex, if it's a friend, this is also possible. Okay, yes, these cards are called romance angels, and of course they have a romantic touch, but this is a general tarot reading. So you can take the romance angels messages, of course, and apply them to different social aspects of your life, like friendships or family members, okay? Let your friends help you, ask for and accept support from others, and maybe for you, the time is here to come out of the hermit mode and see that there are many, many people around you that do love you, Cancer. Don't forget that. Religious factors. Your love life is influenced by your religious upbringing and spiritual path. Make the effort. Great love is worth taking the steps you're guided to take. And now, look at this, nice. This is very interesting. Keep an open mind. Your soulmate may differ from your usual type and expectations. Heart-to-heart conversations. Honestly, discuss your feelings with each other. And this could be the one you've already met, the romantic partner you seek. And we have the Two of Cups, and I was talking about a soulmate here coming into your life. For some of you, this could be a brand new person because we have your soulmate may differ from your usual type and expectations. We have this could be the one you've already met, the romantic partner you seek. So for others of you, this could also be someone you already know. And this person could become very, very important to you, Cancer. Okay? So all in all, I love this beautiful, beautiful transformation of your energies, of the energies in your life, to this powerful Empress energy, this powerful Ace of Pentacles. Don't forget, the energies are shifting. You are coming out of the Three of Swords, of this heartbreaking situation, and there is hope. There is a better future, of course, Cancer, always, okay? Thank you so much for watching. If you want to support me and my channel, please leave a thumbs up. You can leave a comment down below, and I would be happy if you would subscribe to my channel. And I do have Twitter and Instagram as well, where I post weekly taroscopes and intuitive messages. So if you're interested in that, make sure to follow me over there as well. And I do see you next time, maybe for your singles reading. Okay, bye guys. Thank you so much.